morning. This is our first class, and in this class we study paper 2.
Paper 2, that is solid state physics.
And in that paper we will study unit 2,
that is magnetic properties of matter.
So magnetic materials are mainly classified in the three groups. First is the
diamagnetic material. Second is the paramagnetic material. And third is the ferromagnetic material.
Okay, so these are the three types of magnetic material: diamagnetic material, paramagnetic material, and ferromagnetic material. So we will be first diamagnetic material. So what is the definition of diamagnetic material? So diamagnetic material are those materials which are repelled by the magnet and which, when placed in the non-uniform magnetic field, so these moves from stronger to weaker part of the field. Means first, repelled by the magnet. Repelled by magnet, and which, when placed in the non-uniform magnetic field, moves from stronger to weaker part of the field. Okay, so this is the definition of diamagnetic material. Then we will see properties. So example first. Example of diamagnetic materials are bismuth. Second, alcohol, water, then gold, silver, and etc. So these are all the familiar examples of diamagnetic materials, and which we will already know these materials: alcohol, water, gold, silver. Okay, so then next, properties of diamagnetic material. Properties of diamagnetic materials. So in these properties, first is the, when diamagnetic material placed in the magnet, in the between the two magnets, north and south pole, the material tends itself at right angle to the lines of forces of the magnet. See this diagram. This is the north pole and this is the south pole, and we place between this magnetic field, this is the material. Okay, and these materials tends itself at right angle to these lines of forces. If we draw these lines of forces, and in according to these lines of forces, this is right angle, means 90 degree with each other. Okay, means parallel, perpendicular to each other. This is the first property. Second property, as according to definition, when diamagnetic material placed in the magnetic non-uniform magnetic field, so this moves from stronger to weaker part of the field. This is the second characteristic, moves stronger to weaker part. So then next, third property is the, when diamagnetic material placed in the non-uniform magnetic field, the lines of forces tends away from the material, means it push itself away from the material, means they cannot penetrate the material. So this is the next one, property of diamagnetic material. When we place the material, diamagnetic material between the magnetic field, the lines of forces tend itself away from the material. Okay. Then next one. Fourth property. Magnetic susceptibility value of diamagnetic material is very small. Susceptibility, magnetic susceptibility denoted by the letter this psi, and this is for diamagnetic materials we write here suffix di, is less than unity. Means very small but negative value. Okay, less than unity but it has the negative value. For example, bismuth. Bismuth has a value, susceptibility value for bismuth equals to minus 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 8. So this is the value for bismuth. Minus means negative value. Susceptibility of diamagnetic material value is negative, that is minus 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 8. This is for the bismuth. Okay. So next one, property, and the susceptibility value psi, it is independent of, means it does not depend on the strength of the magnetic field and with respect to temperature. It is independent of strength of the magnetic field and it is independent of the temperature. Means there is a no relation between the temperature and the strength of the magnetic field. If there is a decrease in temperature, increase in temperature, no matter. Okay. Means it is independent. And last property, mu r, relative permeability value. Means the relative permeability value of diamagnetic material is less than 1, means it is small. It has the small value of relative permeability and it is less than 1. So these all are the properties of diamagnetic materials. Then second is the paramagnetic material. Paramagnetic material. So the definition of paramagnetic materials. Paramagnetic materials are those materials which are attracted, weakly attracted by the magnet. Weakly attracted by the magnet. We will see in the last topic, that is diamagnetic material. It is a repelled by the magnet, and in paramagnetic material this is weakly attracted by the magnet, and when it places in the non-uniform magnetic field it moves from weaker to stronger part of the field. Weaker to stronger part of the field. So this is the definition of paramagnetic materials, which is weakly attracted by the magnet, and when it placed in the non-uniform magnetic field moves from weaker to stronger part of the field. The family examples are aluminium, oxygen, manganese, so and etc. So these are the familiar examples. There are lots of examples, but we will taking one or two examples, and we write here also one or two examples in the exam. So these are the familiar examples of paramagnetic materials. Then properties. Properties of paramagnetic material. So first property, when we place paramagnetic material in the non-uniform magnetic field. This is the paramagnetic material placed in the non-uniform magnetic field. The lines of forces moves inside the material, means penetrate itself in the material. Means it can pass through the paramagnetic materials. Lines of forces can penetrate within the material or inside the materials and go outside the south pole. Means we can say that the lines of forces penetrate through the material. So this is the first property of paramagnetic material. Second, As according to definition, when the paramagnetic material plays in the non-uniform magnetic field, this moves from weaker to stronger part of the field. This is the second property. According to definition, moves from stronger to weaker part of the field. Sorry, weaker to stronger. So this is the second property. Then third property is with respect to susceptibility. Susceptibility value for paramagnetic material is small but not negative. Okay, here for paramagnetic material, then the magnetic susceptibility of the paramagnetic material value is small but not negative, it is the positive value and it is very small value. And for this, Curie is the name of scientist. He say that this susceptibility value for paramagnetic material is inversely proportional to the absolute temperature. Means susceptibility is inversely proportional to the temperature, and if remove this proportion, it will be some constant. So that's why psi magnetic value for paramagnetic material is equal to C by T. And this C is the constant called Curie constant. Curie constant.